Good day. My name is Vlad Kaczyński. I'm coming from the same source, University of Washington. Yes, and I am proud having such an excellent company and recognition of the Fulbright programs in the knowledge and experience and capabilities to share it with Chile, for example. So thank you very much, and I'm proud to be in the team. I'm retired, of course, but from my accent, you can deduct quickly that I am of Polish ancestry. I was born in Poland, and I came to the United States as a Fulbright scholar. So basically, all my affiliation with the University of Washington started with the Fulbright connection that was promoted by the Embassy of the United States in Warsaw during the communist time at the time. So today, when I am here, I feel that it is a good time for me to reciprocate and to pay my debt, in this sense that the United States Department of State and universities recognized my possibility of contributing to the some kind of knowledge, particularly at the time when the United States extended national jurisdiction over 200 my economic zone. I was only expert from communist countries at the time to answer what would be the reaction of the Soviet Union and many other communist bloc countries to the extended national jurisdiction established by the United States at that time. So basically my general education, experience and interest are in marine affairs, in contrast to my magnificent predecessors who were dealing more with the earth related issues or other issues of the great importance. I focus on my marine affairs, particularly international and developing countries. All the, my career is just working in Africa, Latin America, Asia, etc. So today I would like to basically present objectives of my mission more than the background or related questions that are driving my willingness or interest to address these issues. Basically, the whole reason for me to come here is to contribute to the better level of academic training and research in the School of Marine Science, Department of Geography, Pontifical University of the Catholic University of Valparaiso, where I already had the honor to be about 4 years ago, to 2014. And today I will say that it is kind of continuation or very clear dwelling on achievements of the previous mission. That is just the reason of my presence here. Just a moment. First, let me quickly inform why I have selected Chile for my Fulbright assignments in marine affairs. As everybody knows, Chile belongs to the group of unique countries of such a long exposure, a border line to the ocean. And therefore, and because the country is kind of the narrow but long, the impact of marine economy, environment, and other is tremendous, and it must be reflected in any research and education. Besides, Chile is a leading economy of the South American continent, and we are dealing with a very stable economic system that is attracting foreign, not only capital investment, but also collaboration and willingness to transfer the further knowledge to our colleagues here in this country. I lived in Chile already 4 years before, and I speak fluent Spanish. But I, if you wish, I can make it in this language, but I don't know if it will be acceptable or Espanol. Si ustedes quieren, con gran placer podría continuar en castellano. Pero eso depende de los que... Usted me va a decir. Should I continue English or Spanish? Whatever.
I don't speak much Spanish.
Okay, so yes, let's go in English, and particularly that is this also in English. Basically, the challenges that the country is facing as far as the use of the abundant resources along economic zone, I mean, and wide economic zone, and opportunities that exist in this country, not used until today. It is one, it's a group of motivations that that bring me here, and I am gladly sharing this experience. The purpose of the project is multiple. I will say that first to increase academic training, and this training might be focusing on initial even to discuss the PhD program. They want to have some information. I mean, I say they want professors from the school, and also compare the master degree program in the School of Marine and Environmental Affairs, University of Washington, with that School of Marine Science here in Chile. I have also some research projects assigned already to do, including the evaluation of the contribution of marine economy to the general economy of Chile, and also assess the possibility of changing, improving lives of southern Chile ethnic populations that are just right now trying to restore their old rights to the resources that exist in that area, southern Chile. So here I just mentioned the PhD program, which will be only just to introduce, no revolution. I don't expect that I will be able to to incentivize the establishment. It will take many years to go this way. However, there are some possibilities of exchanging experience, which we have. Master degree, as I mentioned, also is the important aspect of my work, and basically comparative study to show what we did and what has been done here and what can be improved, what cannot be accepted, and so this is very flexible. Finally, I will say, as far as the socio-economic issues are concerned, we already 4 years ago we visited southern Chile and the ethnic populations of Lafkenche and Huilliche, who are very much interested to develop their resource harvesting and processing and marketing activities. This experience will be then supported by Alaska ethnic populations that have been recognized by the government of the United States and local institutions, and they, thanks to the allocation of resources, increased substantially their level of living. And we wanted to compare what was done in Alaska with ethnic populations, called before Eskimo, but we would call them this way, how they are doing right now, what was specifically initiated after 10 or 15 years. We already have a lot of results. And therefore, the experience from the north could be perhaps analyzed and compared and used for the increased benefits of the local populations. as I mentioned, increased contribution of fisheries and aquaculture sectors, and their social dimensions is an important aspect of my mission. And Chile's fishery sector is very significant. Basically, we don't have any data how much this contribution, economic contribution, social, and that, to the national economy is done by both sectors. And I am going to interact with different institutions and organizations just to collect sufficient data and use American experience and Canadian experience too in evaluations and answering the question, what is the role, what is the place of these two important sectors in Chilean maritime economy. I was also asked, because I'm a kind of internationalist, specializing in international affairs, to deliver series of presentations or seminars that are dealing with the international aspects of the marine sector. Chile is extremely interested and dependent on international trends and changes that happen. And I have selected a number of topics that might be of interest both for faculty, students, and the general public, including perhaps even in other universities, if we agree, for example, Pontifical Catholic University of Santiago, for example. And this is a series of questions or issues of great importance for Chilean, both academia and the public, I mean also private sector government, including such important questions like illegal and unreported and underestimated activities at sea, which affects tremendously Chilean economy. Chilean Jack Mackerel, if you have heard, is a tiny example of intercepting the potential benefits of Chile by international operators of open ocean is one, for example, issue. Another is a very important trend, which is not well known, of marine expansion of China. China is looking for resources and not only in Africa, Asia, but also now in South America, particularly Pacific, Peru, partially Ecuador, but Peru, and now Chile. They are simply buying companies and become the controllers of this, of all benefits and potential future is in Chinese hands. Naturally, we wanted to also show to compare how other countries are doing, because I have experience traveling to different countries, Africa and South America. And one issue that perhaps will be of interest is the marine hazards and crisis management. It is also another maritime, let's say, question that is very important to consider in case particularly of Chile, like tsunamis or coastal earthquakes, etc. And finally, there is a joint venture business in South America, which is perhaps peculiar, because most countries in South America restricted access of foreign operators in their 200-mile economic zone. No foreign flag. However, there were ways and are ways to bypass this type of regulations, and Chinese, Koreans, and particularly Asian countries are doing quite well by joint venturing and replacing older ships from South America by their own, changing the flag. Flag is changed. Crew might be even local or partially local, but money and profits fly to to Beijing or Seoul or whatever. So those are the issues of importance, of interest, of the international nature currently very active and of great interest for, I believe, for my colleagues in the university in Valparaiso and in Santiago. So with this, I would like to basically conclude. And of course, I have received tremendous support from the School of Marine Science. Without this, my mission will not be possible. But there is a recognition that contacts established 4 years ago still are of interest to continue by them. So I'm very proud. Thank you very much.
We'd have time for a couple of questions.
I think that for data science,
yes,
can help you by looking at the historical record that you may have.
Certainly so.
And based upon the current conditions, and you can analyze not only trends, you can only know if there's decline in population of some particular.
Yes, we use this data from different international organizations and local institutes and our own research. Yes, yes, it is very.
And you can bring it to your own input.
Yes, it's quantitative with qualitative implications. Yes.
Well, thank you again. Thank you very much. It's very interesting. I did have one question. I think you mentioned the indigenous Alaskans are planning to collaborate here with.
Basically, my first mission in 2014 was to bring an experience of indigenous Alaskan population, coastal populations, experience gained by different reforms, changes, improvements, and achievements, to show all the people of the southern Chile, where we traveled and we had interviews with leaders there. And we are right now preparing the peer review article in Ocean Development and International Law Journal to show that Chile, although it signed and ratified the ILO Convention 169, that is forcing or at least committing the government to recognize more self-determination and independence and preferences of the ethnic populations that were deprived through Spanish colonization and Chilean later continuation of this, from the access to the resources, natural, both marine and forest and fresh water. Without access to the resources of this sort, as seen from Alaska experience, there is no way these people in the South will get out from the continuing poverty and deprivation of the opportunities to expand, to grow, and to become more independent. They are citizens of Chile. They are brothers, sisters, but of those who live in the north, for example. But the question is what we can do in order to improve the lives of these people who are in continuing poverty. Therefore, lesson from Alaska is that by allocating resources and, of course, controlling the use and helping, because there is a question of knowledge, experience, we know very well, there is a chance that those populations, those people will improve their lives, and they will be more happy than before.